श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार्किके केसरी वेदांताचार्य वर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि नमो नारायण ऑन दिस ताई फ्राइडे ऑस्पिशियस डिवाइन वंडरफुल डे द फर्स्ट फ्राइडे वी विल स्टार्ट ए सीरीज ऑन श्री महालक्ष्मी सो इट्स ऑडियंस ग्रीड और पेरासाइ टू टारगेट attempting to talk about Chatushloki. Yamunacharya, also called as Alavandar, has composed two slokas, has blessed us with two Sri Suktis. One is Chatushloki and other is Stotra Ratnam. And it is a rash attempt to cover both in this series. First, of course, Chatushloki, which itself will take quite a long time. And Sri Mahalakshmi is a central concept, Mahalakshmi Tattvam, to Sri Vaishnavam. To Sri Vaishnavas, she is known as Sri Devi or Vishnu Patni, and Perumal is called Sriyaf Pati. So Sri Mahalakshmi as Periya Pirati, she is glorified in Vedas as well as in Pancharatra, in Vaikhanasa. She is also glorified in Itihasa Puranas. She is glorified in Divya Prabandhams by Alvar saints. She is glorified by Devendra Indran and in Indra Stuti in Vishnu Puranam. And there is a Lakshmi Ashtotra Stotram. There are Lakshmi Sahasranama Stotrams. There are two, it reported to be two. And Yamunacharya's Chatushloki, four slokas on Mahalakshmi. Swami Desigan, Periyavachan Pillai, have blessed us with extensive, wonderful, exhaustive commentaries on Chatushloki. And Sri Kurathalvan has also blessed us with Sri Stavam on Mahalakshmi. The Mahalakshmi Ranganayaki is almost like an adopted son, is Sri Parasara Bhattar, the son of illustrious Kurathalvan. He blessed us with Sri Gunaratna Kosham on Mahalakshmi. And of course, Swami Desikan Sri Stuti is there. Mahalakshmi is our divine mother. She is our mother, where Perumal and Tayar are like the Divya Dampati. She is the personification of compassion. She blesses us with all Aishwaryams. And this Mahastotram is on Mahalakshmi and her Karunyam. In spite of all that she gives us, grants us, for everything that we have is all because of Mahalakshmi's grace. And in spite of all that, she always thinks and feels ashamed that she has not given us enough. In fact, Parasara Bhattar himself says in one slokam that why are you lowering your eyes and not looking at us? Is it because you are Pativratai? That's not the case. How can the mother feel towards her own children and not to look at them? That's because of her audharyam. She feels ashamed that she is not being able to give us enough in spite of giving everything to us. And she never ever get separated from her Lord Sriman Narayana. And Ramanuja has also blessed us with one paragraph when he performs Prapati in Sharanagati Gadyam to Mahalakshmi. And Yamunacharya, also called as Alavandar, starts off with Chatushloki before he composes Stotra Ratnam. And this is the first of the stotrams in Sri Vaishnavam by our acharyas. And Alavandar has written wonderfully about Mahalakshmi and her grace and praises in a very impregnated words, fully loaded with extensive meaning. Kainkaryam avade seshi uganda yeval tholil seivade. Kainkaryam is doing what pleases the Divya Dampati, the Seshi. So that is why he probably started off with a praise on Mahalakshmi, so that people recite that through vak, and thereby he pleases Mahalakshmi there, asking and facilitating all of us to praise Mahalakshmi. So we, the Dasabhutas or servants of Divya Dampati, should always behave in a manner that pleases them, the Divya Dampatis. And hence, we should either meditate, perform dhyanam, or perform namaskaram, or praise them in terms of stotrams, or composing, or writing, or talking, or enjoying the translations, all that. So, that at least facilitates others to also listen and share this anubhavam when we do through vak. And hence Swami chooses to write, compose these slokas. So, and if he writes in Vedanta Artams in prose form, it would not be that good, it would not be that nice or pleasing. It would be in a lilting verse form. We recite, it's good to listen, it's like it's musical to the ears. And even if we do not know the meaning, Mahalakshmi knows the meaning, and she understands, and she feels pleased at our recitation of those stotrams. However, if we get to know the meanings, it would be all the more awesome to enjoy the stotrams, knowing fully well or little bit about the meanings or content of the stotrams. And hence, it's necessary for our own enjoyment these to get to know the meanings of these. So Swami Desikan, we will follow closely Swami Desikan and Paramakarunikar Periyavachan Pillai's Vyakyanam on Chatusloki while we take up this in our Avatarikai and the four stotrams in subsequent sessions. And all these compositions on Mahalakshmi or Periyapirati have got no parallel to any other religion or any other philosophy. There are these compositions on Sri Sukti have talked about her unbounded, limitless daya, her benevolence, her being the means as well as the goal, upayam and upayam, her purushakaram, the mediatrix, as the recommendation for us and the Lord. And thus, she has a unique position of being a Sri Vishnu, Sriman Narayana's divine consort, as well as our darling mother, Akhila Jagan Mata and Asmat Mata. She and Swami says that while the Lord Sriman Narayana takes the role of Dandadaratvam to punish the trans of the people who are transgressing against Shastras, and all of us are in that category, whereas she forgives us to recommend our pitiable case to him for protecting us and for saving us. And for that, she expects us just to return to her and look up to her as complete sarnagati to her, and otherwise she would be partial to few only. So she just needs a vyajyam, a pretext, and just look at her, and that's adequate. So in Chatusloki, Yamuna Charya thus focuses on Purushagara Prapati, the Ekaseshitvam, Upayam and Upayam. And he says they are the Divya Dampatis are inseparable. Agalagille Irayumenne Alamel Mange Urai Marban. And she is known as Vishnu Patni. He is known as Sriyapati. She, on her own accord, serves Sriman Narayana. In fact, in Pancharatra Samhita, Mahavishnu tells Vishvaksena, his senior most disciple, the qualities of Mahalakshmi. He says that she is the resting place for all acharyas. She is the ruler of all worlds. And she is the, just like the universe is pervaded by me, both in essence and the quality, all these things are pervaded by her also. She is the ruler. She is pervaded by me and I am pervaded by her. The difference between me and her is that she, who is the ruler of everyone, is on her own accord is subservient to me. To her, as well as the universe, I am the Lord. Whereas she is also a Bhagavati for the entire universe. And that is well known in Vedas as well. Swami Sriman Narayana says in Pancharatra Samhita, thus Sri Mahalakshmi herself has explained, and her consort, their rulership, and Sri Vatsya Guru, Vatsya Varada Guru, Nadadur Ammal, mentions in Prapanna Parijatam also the relationship between the divine couple. That supreme Brahman, which is as his luster to the moon, goddess Lakshmi to Sriman Narayana. And Brahman and Sriman Narayanan and Mahalakshmi are inseparable and Ekaseshi for us. We will get back on the subsequent session more on Chatusloki as Avatarikai and continue. ஆளவந்தார் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஆச்சாரியன் திருவடிகளே சரணம். கவிதார்க்கிக சிம்மாய கல்யாண குணசாலினே ஸ்ரீமதே வெங்கடேஷாய வேதாந்த குரவே நமஹா.